My beloved speaks and says to me, "Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now, the winter is past. The rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time of singing has come. And the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines are in blossom. Arise, my love. Arise, my fair one, and come away. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If one offered for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly scorned."
I'd like everybody right now, if you would, to take hands to your neighbor. And let's just take a quiet moment. And let's focus on them and feel and give them our power and our faith for their future. And take a lovely moment of peace and a lovely moment of direction for what it means for them to be together.
Take you, Robert, to be my husband.
To love and cherish until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
Laura, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
You may kiss the bride.
To all of you fathers of daughters out there, I hope you are as fortunate as I am that your daughter will find someone as kind-hearted, generous, and pure as Bobby Weibel. Given your mother and me happy memories of the past, joyful moments of the present, and the hope and promise of the future.
God bless you both. I love you both so much, as does everybody in this room, and I wish you all the best.